Greetings, offspring of my old foe. It's time we spoke, you and I. But first, let's make sure we're not bothered by any of your so-called friends. This is a private matter. Get trivial matters out of the way first. Do you know who I am? As opposed to what? Some grisly avatar like the Slayer? A cloud of smoke? A massive face in the sky with a booming voice? I am only here to talk, to gauge your threat to me, if any. If only things were so easy as that. But if I get involved in the whole Baalspawn mess, then my own opponents amongst the gods would intervene. Mistra, or Kellenvor, perhaps. And it seems that Eo, the Overfather, has an interest in this as well. Which is very odd. He wishes this little climactic end for the Baalspawn to play itself out without interference from the rest of us. And so I, the great Sirik, am restricted to watching and observing. And yet, if there is anyone who should feel threatened by a child of the former Lord of Murder, it is me. There is just no justice anymore. I've been watching your progress for a while. Very impressive. I've formed a few conclusions, but let's hear it from the horse's mouth. How much should I fear you? This level of the abyss, this throne of Baal, would give me such problems. If only I could have destroyed it to begin with. I didn't need it. I didn't want it. I have my own plane in Pandemonium, thank you very much. Much better than anywhere in the abyss. But obviously I should have paid more attention to this dismal place. But it's no matter. Can't undo what's already been done. And if you try, then that leads to all sorts of different problems. And I'd rather not open that bag of worms once again. As for you, you might decide to see my realm of influence. If you even get that far, that is. But it remains to be seen if you even have the power to attempt it. Never mind succeed. I think you need to be tested. That is what you created these little rooms for, isn't it? To test yourself. Mistra and Eo couldn't fault me for aiding you towards that end now, could they? Perhaps we will meet again. For now, let us see how you do against my favor. I suggest you prepare yourself.
On my honor.
Yes?
What is it now?
Nature's servant awaits.
How may I assist?
Yes? What?
On my arm!
I am yours to command.
Yes? What is my task? Consider it done.
What can I do? The group needs me? I simply have no room.
On my honor, I will do my best.
Needs me?
What is my task?
Sire?
Beat up. More.
This is a lot more exciting.
My weapon has no effect. On my honor. Solid. My best.
Swords, not words!
Yes, yes.
What can I do?
On my arm. Yes? Very well.
Ooh! Shiny ones!
What is my task? Done.
Sapinar is good servant! Oh, yes!
As you step into the abyssal plane, the first thing that strikes you is how suddenly alien it feels. A chill wind sweeps across an empty void, screaming in your ears that you are not welcome here. Several strange towering structures are present, suspended in the void by an unknown power. All your immortal senses tell you, however, that the powerful essence of your dead father is close. And that this place is indeed the throne of Baal.
I see you have finally found your way to the throne of Baal. You should know, however, that far too late.
Mahamira! At your order!
On my honor.
I should not be wasting time on you. I still have to absorb the Volsbar essences. And there is more than enough power in this room to keep you busy.
Thank you.
Very well.
Until I say it is!
do nothing in Melisar but accept your fate. The time that was mentioned has come, Bad Channel. There is a choice before you. You have prevailed against all that have assailed you, and now you must decide your fate. The vast majority of the soul essences, children of Baal, Lord of Nero, now belong to you and you alone. You must now decide what to do with this power. There are consequences with all decisions. This one, however, is unique in its scope. I will attempt to explain it as best I can. First, you may choose to surrender that portion of the essence which remains with you. It shall be given to Amelisar, and her soul, with all the essence it contains, shall be destroyed. You may think this brutal, but Amelisar has welded the essence to her own soul. Foolishly. And there is no other way. The price of ambition is always right. Surrendering the essence will allow the gods to renew this little tent and hide it well within the halls of Mount Celestia, forever preventing it from soiling your soul. You, Ballspot, would be made immortal, free to continue your life with the destiny of your own choosing. The manipulations of gods will no longer be your concern, and your soul will be untainted. Once Amelisar's soul is destroyed and the essence released, you may accept it into yourself if you want it, and the throne of Baal will be yours to command. The taint of evil within the totality of Baal's essence is great, greater than anything you have ever known. It remains to be seen whether it will resist this evil or embrace it. Regardless, you will receive your enemies from amongst the gods. Should the spirit usurp the sire's role, the edict of Al the Everfather, would gain interest in the others. Your future is unwritten, but once chosen, the gods know that it will be of significance to the universe. You will have few allies, and your trials will not end anytime soon. The choice is difficult, but these are your two options, Valspar. This is where your destiny is realized, and your future
I would caution you if I could. Great power comes with its own temptations and its own trials. Have you not been through enough? I think you would be happier in the end living your own life. But I would not think to speak for you, my friend. If you succumbed to temptation and became an evil power, however, it would serve me to think I fought so long to support such an ending.
No. Oh, say it is not so. We will come out and fight you together. Who will miss you? Forever shall we hang our heads in sadness, in remembrance of our great bath-keeping friend. Bo and I will say, we knew the hero, and people will of course not believe us, and maybe they will look at us more strangely than they do now. Or maybe not.
It seems my promise to Borain is last avenue. It would be difficult to watch you move on to a higher state of being, if that is where you choose to go. But you hardly need my guidance any longer. What a terrible thing to decide. You fought for so long to get to this point. If you choose to keep all this power, there will be nothing more than more fighting.
You would seek to rise up to the ranks where Helm resides? It is astounding that such a thing is even possible. Do as you feel you must. While I would miss your presence, I cannot advise you.
The time has come to make your choice, Bob. What is your wish? Then you shall begin life anew, mortal, without the taint of your sire upon your soul, and the essence of Bob shall be forever. Done well, and freedom shall be your reward. Your decision has been made, Godchild. Now the act must be carried out.
divine essence slowly fades, and for a moment you feel empty, incomplete. It is frightening, but soon yields to a new sensation, one of hope. With your closest companions at your side, you are free to live out your mortal life, no longer a pawn of Baal's prophecy. The adventure draws to a close, but there will be more to come. Even as a mortal, you are to be looked upon in awe, and your power commands attention, both friendly and otherwise. Your life is yours, as are the trials to come. As years pass, tales of your exploits shall spread far and wide, and bards will sing your name along with heroes and villains of legend. Your life may be mortal, your time now finite, but the mark you have left upon the realms will endure.